In today's tutorial, we will see how to highlight a row of the active cell. So if we select a cell, the entire row should get highlighted. In this video, we will see two examples. The first example is for the data set which is not an official Excel table. And the second example where the selection of row is done in the Excel table. But before we start, here is our intro. If you are finding us for the first time, do subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video. For the purpose of this tutorial, I have prepared two sheets. In the first sheet, the data is kept in a normal data set. That means this is not an official Excel table. But in sheet number 2, the data is kept in an official Excel table. The aim of this tutorial is that if any of the cell within the data set is selected, the entire row should get highlighted. This can be achieved using conditional formatting and a VBA. To run VBA or macros in Excel worksheet, the file needs to be saved as Excel Micro Enabled Workbook, which is .xlsm. Also, we will enable the developer tab. For that, we'll go to the ribbon, right click on it and click on customize ribbon. We'll click the checkbox near to the developer tab and click on OK. This will enable the developer tab for the use of VBA. Firstly, we'll take the data set which is not an official Excel table and take the conditional formatting part first. The formula which we will be using for conditional formatting is equal to cell and we will use the row option and close the bracket. If I select any cell and press F9, which will recalculate the sheet, it will give me the current row. If I change the cell selection and again recalculate using the F9 key, it will give me the current row. But conditional formatting need a formula which returns a boolean value. So we will add a check using the current row number formula. This formula, we will copy it and use it in the conditional formatting. Now we will select our entire data excluding the header and add few additional rows. Depending upon your future growth of your data set, you can add as many as additional rows you like. Go to the Home tab and click on Conditional Formatting and select New Rule. We will use this option, Use a Formula, to determine which cell to format, and we will paste the copied formula. The next step is to format the cell. We will click on Format button. This will pop up the Format Cell window. We will go to the Fill option, select first any color and then select the Fill effect. We will use the two color gradient for horizontal. We will select color number 1 and color number 2. Since our background color is a dark one, we will change the font color to white and use the bold option and click on OK. We will again click on OK. Now we have created a conditional formatting for the selected range. Let's test it out. We'll select a cell in the selected range and press on F9 key. We'll change the cell selection and press on F9 key. Again, we'll change the selection and press the F9 key. But here the problem is that the blank cell also gets highlighted. For that, we have to make some tweaks to the formula of the conditional formatting. For that, we'll go to the Home tab, click on Conditional Formatting and select Manage Rules. We'll select the rule which we made earlier. click on edit rule, and in the formula we will add the AND logic. Our first logic will be the previous formula, and the second logic we will select the first cell of the range. We will remove the log reference for the rows and use less than and greater than sign for the null value. We close the bracket and click on OK. And again OK. Let's test again. We'll select the cell inside the data cell and press on F9. We'll select outside the data set and press on F9. Now every time there is a selection change, we were using F9 key to recalculate the sheet. To avoid this, we will write a small code in the VBA. For that, we'll go to the developer tab and click on Visual Basic. This will open the Visual Basic editor screen. We'll double click on the sheet number 1 which we are working on it. From the drop down, from the first drop down we will select the worksheet, and from the second drop down we will select the selection change. Between the private sub and end sub of worksheet selection change, we'll write a single line of code which is application.calculate. This sub procedure will run when there is a selection change of the cell. We'll exit the Visual Basic editor and go back to our sheet. Let's test it now. So whenever there is a cell selection change, the row gets highlighted. And if we go out with the data set, even though it is within the conditional formatting range, it will not highlight. Now let's take the second example where the data set is in the official Excel table. As before, we will use the conditional formatting and VBA, but with a different method. The benefit of using an Excel table is that it can be named and its range expands automatically whenever there is a new row added beneath the last row. If we select the entire data of the table, we can see the range as a sales data. This we will use it to use in the VBA. But first, let's set up the conditional formatting. In this method, we will need a support row, so we will add one row above our title. Go to the Home tab, click on Insert and select Insert Sheet Row. This will add an additional row above the title. In the end, we are going to hide this row. We will write here selected row number and we'll put some value in B1. Let's say we'll put 11. The idea is to whatever number is available in B1, the same row should get highlighted. So let's set up the conditional formatting first. For that, we'll select the table, go to the Home tab and click on Conditional Formatting, New Rule. In the Conditional Formatting New Rule, we will use the formula type rule to determine our condition. And in the formula, we will write equal to, select the cell B1, again write equal to, and row open bracket and close bracket. We'll set the format as previous. We'll fill in with the fill effects, gradient, horizontal. And again we will use the white color and a bold effect. We'll click on OK. And we will again click on OK. So now if I change the number to 13, the highlighted row change. If I again change the number to 9, then the row number 9 gets highlighted. To automatically change the value of cell B1 after the selection change, we will use VBA. For that, we will go to the developer tab and click on Visual Basic. Since we are working on sheet number 2, we will double click sheet number 2. With the first down drop, we will select Worksheet, and with the second drop down, we will select Selection Change. I have already written the code which I will explain. The first line is if not intersect, open bracket target, which is our selected cell, comma, range, this is our table, is nothing. So basically what we are doing with this statement is that not intersect and is nothing, both are negative, will become positive. So we are looking for intersect of the target and our table. If it is true, then the value of B1 will change to the selected cell row. So let's remove the stop sign and test our sheet. And the final thing we will do is write in the VBA to hide this row. So we'll go back again to the editor, and in the last line we will write rows, open bracket, our row number is 1, close bracket, hidden equal to true. That's it. We have completed with our coding, and we'll close the VBA editor. Let's test it now. So even if you open this row on selection, it will hide automatically. If you need to copy the conditional formatting formula and the VBA code of both the example, I'll put it in the description box. You can copy it from there. I hope you like this video. If you are not subscribed yet, subscribe to this channel, give this video a thumbs up, and share this video with your friends.